The Small Town Living Fusion Project, Arts Create Community, Economic Development and Wellness, was inspired by years of involvement with the small cities of Nazareth in the center of the Northwest Texas Panhandle, New Smyrna Beach on Central Florida's Atlantic coast, and Liberty in upstate South Carolina's Blue Ridge foothills. As a socially engaged playwright, I've been privileged to play a small part in the residents' lives and collaborate with them as they face challenges which demand the need for change in order to survive. The artistic passions of the people in these communities provide a critical engine for community unity, economic growth, and wellness, while illuminating and creating history beyond pure data. Nazareth, New Smyrna Beach, and Liberty each represent an individual approach to the arts' role in small city dynamics and survival as they personify the heart of America's cultural foundation. Much has been written by arts educators, economists, and historians about the existence of the arts and its impact on human culture. And it's well documented that the arts are a commodity to be bought, sold, and traded. The more elusive qualities of the arts must be experienced to be appreciated. They nurture spiritually, mentally, and physically beyond pure data and affect every aspect of community life. It's through an understanding of how the arts create community, economic development, and wellness that we have a window to the survival of our unique American culture, one that embraces the history of all the cultures of our planet. As we move forward in our quest to journey to Mars, we will carry with us the timeless effect of the arts, a living metaphor and history of our humanity.
In 2015, the dance world lost jazz innovator, educator, and entertainer, Eugene Luigi Fasciuto. His influence on icons of the entertainment field, as well as dance educators and students, lives on through his unique style and ability to heal spirit, mind, and body. Luigi's inspirational story of survival against all odds and his ability to teach that to others lives on through the people who knew him and his jazz technique. Wherever he taught throughout the globe, he created a sense of community, contributed to local economies, and generated wellness. Luigi understood that all artists strive within the shadow of the genius of those who have come before and those who will follow. He was the quintessential artist who lived for his art and supported the dreams of other artists. Luigi taught until the end of his life at age 90, and his protege and associate, Francis K. Roach, continues Luigi's legacy at the Luigi Jazz Center in New York and beyond. The tradition lives on.
It's both wonderful and challenging when history stares you in the face at the same time as the present and future. It's our connections to each other and the past which breathe life into us. They come and go too quickly, and the future is now. But we can reach out and touch them forever. Most of all, we can embrace them as part of our being, because they are part of our journey, past, present, and future.
How do we measure time? It feels ephemeral in nature. Past, present, and future melding within a kaleidoscopic adventure. Relationships, especially bound by love, bind the ties of time. All we've ever been, are, and will be, are interwoven with everyone we've ever known and will know, especially those we love. Fact is often stranger than fiction, and fiction seems more real when drawn from the depths of our being. Our yearning compels us to create amazing possibilities.
Nazareth, Texas is a place of survival and lives well lived in the midst of a timeless yet disappearing way of life, an almost magical gift from the Panhandle, where fact and fiction create their own reality. The Panhandle is a part of Texas unfamiliar to most outsiders. Nazareth, between Amarillo and Lubbock, is a small town, hidden from view within the vast open landscape.
On the surface, Nazareth seems forgotten by time, and yet it's as busy as any large city. The land calls out to those who know it well, whether they've stayed on to make a life or are long gone to seek another path. Faith, family, farm, and education bind the ties carried by the ephemeral winds. They whisper the stories of past, present, and future. There's much to say about a disappearing way of life.
Why is anyone attracted to a small town hidden off the main highway? We humans have always wandered the earth in search for a home. Even when we find one, we continue to travel far and wide to distant places, only to return to the land of our heart. Faith, family, farm, and education are at the heart of Nazareth. As far as the eye can see, the land is there to protect and nurture in good times and in bad, as do the church, family, and school. They feed the belly as well as the soul and bind families one to the other.
Shared values nurture love and life which grow in the earth surrounding the home places. Secrets abound, yet are privately held and respected, part of the fabric of being. The church and its cemetery signify the importance of past, present, and future. A feeling of safety and importance reigns supreme within the realities of an ever-changing world.
All the townspeople are rookies at heart, because memories are rich with what was good and innocent, and which can be felt again and again. Simplicity reigns, the ultimate sophistication. Nazareth is its own outer space-related wormhole, providing connections between the past, present, and future. Other small panhandle towns are like black holes, where all has been destroyed and is void of connection. Nazareth thrives as its own time-space continuum, where multiple dimensions meet and all is possible.
The world calls to Nazareans. It isn't always an easy choice. The way of life is changing, and yet it is the same. Mystery abounds in the winds, which turn the modern-day wind turbines, dotting the landscape amidst the ever-present crops. The winds of time often call the children of Nazareth home. Truth lies within the layers of history, and the memories which provide bridges for transformation demanded by the passage of time. Nazareth is a place to feel safe, enjoy recognition, and be rejuvenated by faith, hard work, and education, fueled by generations of family, breathing life into miles of land.
Nature itself, along with technology, provides survival techniques to combat the challenging aspects of nature. While from anywhere in town, you can hear the underlying Benedictine spirit within the church bells tolling that all is well. Listen for the rooster's crow and the low of a cow as the sun rises on the golden spread day.
New Smyrna Beach is a wonderful example of how the arts can transform a small city. Art is everywhere. It's on buildings, in galleries, parks, restaurants, offices, retail shops, and even in public bathrooms. Most of the residents are transplants from various parts of the U.S. Whether they're year-round, snowbirds, or day trippers, they're excited to be a part of the many and varied arts displays and events.
Since the beginning of time, art has brought people together. From earliest man scratching murals on cave walls to the digital walls of the internet age, the sharing of art has served as a means of communication, teaching, and entertainment, turning individuals into groups and uniting us through a shared sense of place, culture, and purpose. But the synchronicity of art-creating community isn't simply a thing of the past. It's alive and well today in the great state of Florida, in the heart of Volusia County, smack dab in downtown New Smyrna Beach, in a place we call The Hub.
In 2012, The Hub on Canal magically appeared in the New Smyrna Beach, Florida Historic District in a building which had been vacant for years. Like the history of most impressive arts organizations, the vision had been processed in the mind of one determined individual for years while witnessing a dropping economy and the opening and closing of countless businesses. In 2009, over coffee, three friends, musician and writer Sally Mackay, ceramic artist Susan Ellis, and jewelry artist Susan Stern, decided to do something about the problem. They used their artistry and other skills to put the vision into action with a strategic plan based on extensive research and financial planning. Their goal was to put feet on the street and lights on at night. Without much more than a lot of hard work by countless community artists and other volunteers, they made the plan into a reality. Artists flocked to the Hub on Canal to become part of the collective story. Storefronts filled up, and the New Smyrna Beach Canal Street Historic District became a destination small city, filled with permanent residents, snowbirds, and day trippers. What began as a sleepy beach town surfboarding community turned into a mecca for artists.
Never too late to find out what your passion in life is and to go for it. But I can tell you in those 8 years, I've hardly stopped to take a breath. It's just been unbelievable. I just can't get enough of it. Most of the time when I sculpt, I take 25 pounds of clay and put it on my modeling stand and I just start working. I don't have an image in my mind as to what it's going to look like, and I'm usually pretty amazed when somebody's looking back at me.
There's four parts of a kimono that was given to me, and it was stained, it was dirty, it had been in somebody's trunk forever, and the person who gave it to me said, "You have my blessing, cut it up, do whatever you want." So it was in my studio for about 9 months. I kept looking at it, and I kept putting fabric up, and I thought, oh, I can't do it. And finally I thought, it needs new life. It's not going to go anywhere. So I took the plunge, cut it up, but I did incorporate, I left some of her hand quilting in there.
The engine of the Hub is a vortex of talented, committed artists who work as a community. Sometimes you've got to give people a reminder of their passion and really not give them what they think they want. They may not know it yet, what they want or need to rekindle this passion.
The Atlantic Center for the Arts in New Smyrna Beach, Florida has an international presence. Associate artist applicants study and collaborate with each other and a master artist. Artists are of the highest caliber. Even when there are language differences, they create unexpected, unique art together. Results exceed expectations. ACA's collaborative, exciting yet peaceful environment in the woods is a short distance from the inspiration of the ocean. As artists get absorbed in the magic rhythm at ACA, creation and collaboration is often chosen over a good night's sleep. Artists are transformed after a residency at the Atlantic Center for the Arts.
Like many longtime residents of New Smyrna Beach, ACA has been a part of my life as long as I can remember. We've grown up together. As membership and marketing director, I find myself connecting to all segments of the community, and I've discovered everyone has a passion that falls somewhere within the arts.
Because the Atlantic Center for the Arts is about process, not product, its arts and wellness program is a process which will evolve over time. Experimentation and collaboration, which are key components of ACA's mission, are evident within its arts and wellness program. The program is based off campus at the Harris House in the New Smyrna Beach Historic District, but activities also occur at ACA's campus, in nursing homes, assisted living facilities, educational institutions, neighborhood venues, and out in nature. The programs include creative caregiving, intuitive painting, expressive journaling through visual art and writing, music and movement, sound walks, team and skill building training, medical arts and psychology internships, and retreats.
A mess, I put on that dress you like, and I pretend that it's not raining outside. I stumble into some shoes I left by the door. Count on both hands the times you hurt me, like 1, 2, 3, 4.
Freedom Quilt is located at Pettis Park in New Smyrna Beach, Florida. It was inspired by Harriet Tubman. I'm so fascinated by her determination to free her people by any means necessary. The quilt was commissioned by Atlantic Center for the Arts and the City of New Smyrna Beach. My vision is to bring in a creative but historical component that would engage the kids and the parents of the community and open them up to learning in a new and exciting experience. Everyone is welcome to participate in the development of the quilt. I am Sharika Morris, Executive Director of P.E.A.C.E. Arts, I am passionate about art and using my art as a platform to change the lives of the kids in the community around me. Art impacts everything around us. Imagine a world without art.
Liberty is nestled between Greenville and Clemson in upstate South Carolina. At the southern edge of the Blue Ridge foothills, it's a critical gateway to the Smoky Mountains. Its lakes, rivers, oak and pine woods, outdoor trails, and a variety of activities ranging from swimming, boating, hiking, biking, the arts, and athletic events, including Clemson University football, make it a natural destination town. Even though it's known for its numerous family-owned and operated eateries, hair salons, and safe walking streets, its reputation is about to expand due to its new Performing Arts Center, public art program, and downtown gentrification. Liberty is a town where neighbors become friends.
Art is inspiration, creativity, originality, passionate expression, and community. As the mayor of Liberty, a city in change, we must complete our canvas with all of these elements. I consider the arts to be an integral piece of our city's gentrification, our culture, and its diversity. As we embrace the future, without art as part of our vision, we will not fully reach our intended economic growth, wellness, or sense of community our citizens deserve.
Welcome to the world of SPARTS. I'm Karen Setlowe, the creator of SPARTS. A fusion of sports, arts, and school studies. SPARTS actively involves students in their learning process. During SPARTS activities in schools, students learn to appreciate their individual skills as they blend sports, arts, and school studies.
Dawson, do you remember that morning? that I accidentally took your pill.
Yes, I did.
I was running around trying to hurry. I reached and took it, and I began to try to get it back up, and I was so upset. I didn't know that I had taken it.
You were like, you didn't mean to take it, and you're like, can't get it out.
I have never told you this. When I graduated from school, we took a train ride to Washington and New York. Well, my sweetheart was Papa, Huey. And so he had just sort of kissed me on the cheek goodbye and waved at me. And he didn't want me to go. He wanted me to stay behind, and I was just wanting to go to Washington so bad. And do you know what he did?
What?
He tried, have you ever heard of this? He tried to outrun the train to Easley.
That's dumb. We always talk about stories in bed.
Do we? Mm-hmm. Do you like that time?
Yeah. We always talk about old times, like when I was a baby. Even people at church. You always tell me that you weren't raised like me, you're raised differently.
Yes.
Because in your time, like when you're little, a lot of things were different.
Mm-hmm. And I tell you, sometimes I would love to take you back there. The days that I grew up.
Why is that?
Hmm?
Why is that?
Because it was just, you just had a lot of time. We were close together, and we, like we said again, we always was telling stories, eating at the table together. And
I love to eat. I still do.
And just having fun together. Yeah. Simple things in life.
Yeah.
But you don't have much time now, do you, hon?
No. Will you still be my family when I get older?
And what does Nana tell you? What do I always say?
You'll always be part of my family.
And that I'll always love you, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
I finally get into the college of my choice, and I'm in a class with a professor of my dreams. He's going on and on about the virtues of art and telling us to breathe in our artistic spirits and embrace it with our whole being. I get caught up in the moment, close my eyes, and imagine myself a sculptor in a perfect studio. But that little voice in my head yells, "How will you breathe in a job? You're going to starve to death."
My art is my subconscious voice, and my sense of community can be anybody at any moment.
Everyone, I'm Carol Butler, and you know how to tap dance.
So I'm going through a divorce, and my mother calls me from Louisiana. Baby, how tall is Bill? Oh, Mom, he's about 6 foot. Why? What color eyes does he have? Oh, they're blue eyes. Mom, why? What are you doing? Would you say that's sandy blonde hair? Yes, Mother, what are you doing? Well, we're at a voodoo shop, and we're going to get that little pissant.
I'm an air-breathing, carbon-based life form, consisting mostly of water. My life in this form is finite, so I try to simplify life in order to have more time to do what I want. When my mother relayed the details of how I was born, I found her story to be implausible, given the size of my head. Eventually, I learned that improbable things happen all the time. In fact, things that were thought to be impossible when I was but a lad are happening even as I speak. So, where is it written that you can't make your living as an artist? I'm the kind of artist who makes art not just because they like to, but because they have to. I have other interests, of course, but making art is what gives life meaning. It's not what I do, it's who I am. There's no objective explanation for it. There's no off switch. It's a need of some kind. To make things whose purpose is contemplation, things that are difficult, things that last. In the end, it all gets laid at your feet, and the question becomes, did you try hard enough? Jacob Bronowski, who would have been one of my heroes if I had heroes, said, "Man is unique among the animals in the joy he takes in exercising and pushing forward his own skills." I think that assertion describes me pretty well.
I go as hard as I can, as long as I can, because I just want to see sometimes what I'm capable of.
A few years ago, we found, working pretty hard here, and our wrists, hands were getting sore. We had a lady come out from the hospital. She was like an occupational therapist, and she kind of looked at what we were doing, gave us some pointers, but mainly the thing she got us doing was these stretching exercises every day, and so it makes a huge difference. We stuck with it, and it helps keep us limber and kind of maybe fight off some of the carpal tunnel syndrome kind of things that we're working with. And for an old man, these exercises are really good about keeping us limber.
I'll be happy if somebody walks up to it and says, "My God, that's beautiful." I've done my job. These are like little missiles. They have a long lifespan, and they're going to go forward in the future. They're my messages to people down the road someplace. Maybe 100 years or 1,000 years from now, one of these pieces of glass might survive. That's good stuff for me.
Thank you.
In the quiet moments of an astronaut's life on the International Space Station, one wonders if writing poetry, playing a musical instrument, quilting, recording video vignettes, or taking creative photographs of outer space soothes and entertains. One can imagine entertainers on Earth performing for the astronauts as they go about their important and highly technical work far away from their everyday lives on Earth. Creativity knows no limitations as to time or place. It's a part of who we are now and forever. Thank you.